In this video, we review the rules for multiplying and dividing numbers when we're keeping track of significant digits. And the rule for multiplication and division is simple. We just round the final answer to the same number of significant digits as the participant with the fewest number of significant digits. So in the first one, we're told that we've used a motion sensor to measure speed and a stopwatch to measure time as we watch a cart move along in a straight line with a constant speed. And that speed measures to 4.1 meters per second. And the time measures to the hundredths place as 2.28 seconds. We want the displacement of the cart, and then we want to express the answer to the correct number of sig figs. So there's a little bit of extra background to this problem. We have to use the formula distance equals rate times time, or more in the style of physics, we could write displacement equals velocity times time. So then we're going to compute the product of 4.1 meters per second and 2.28 seconds, and just as a double check, we make sure the units work out. The seconds cancel, leaving me with meters, so that's good. And we get 9.348 meters. Now we need to round the answer to the correct number of significant digits. So we just look for the participant quantity that had the fewest number of significant digits, and that was the 4.1 that has two significant digits. So we're going to round off to two significant digits as 9.3 meters. And we're done. In the second example, we're told that we've used a scale to measure the mass of an object at 373.1 grams. And the volume was measured at 121 milliliters using the displacement of water in a graduated cylinder. We're asked to find the density of this object in grams per cubic centimeter. And there's a couple of things we need to know here. We need to know that density is mass divided by volume. And we also need to remember that a milliliter is exactly the same thing as a cubic centimeter, so 121 cc's. We plug in our mass of 373.1 grams. We plug in our volume, 121 cc's, and we run the numbers. And we get 3.083 grams per cubic centimeter. There were additional decimals in my calculator, but I know I don't need them, because we're going to round off to three significant digits. That's the number that had the fewest significant digits in the problem. So we're gonna round this down this time because I have a three. We round down to 3.08 grams per cubic centimeter and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.